Hello, my name is Schuyler Smith and I do technical sales and support here at Apogee Instruments. And today we're going to talk about the quick start guide for the AT100 microCache with our IRR sensors, our infrared radiometers that are good for measuring surface temperatures. So in this video, we're going to cover where to download the app from, how to connect to the unit, configuring your sensor, and then how to set up logging, and then how to get those logged values off of your sensor. So, first off, this is where you will find the app. It's available in the Google Play Store and then the iOS App Store. You'll just type in ApogeeConnect, and that is the icon you're looking for. And those are some screenshots that we're going to be going through later on the demonstration. This here is the quick start guide, okay, on how to connect to it and how to add it. We're going to go through each one of these steps individually. This is here for a reference. You can pause the video as needed. This next one is the quick start guide to begin logging, how to set up the logging intervals. And again, you can pause here. And then this is the quick start guide to collecting the logs. So after you've set it up for logging, and then you go back to it, how do you get those logs off so you can view them on your phone? And so those are the steps there. And we're going to go through each one of these. Okay, so this is an iOS version of it, and this is what it's going to look like when you first come in. It's blank, okay, and it has add device right there. Okay, we have our unit, microCache here, we have our IR sensor. Now, I actually already have one added on, so that's what it would look like if you had one added and it's not connected. But if you don't have one at all, then this is what it's going to look like, where it's blank. So, we are going to go ahead and add it. And the way we do this is we're going to push the green button here until it blinks blue. So now it's blinking blue. Now the app's not looking for it yet, so we have to hit the plus button. So we hit the plus button right there. Okay. And it comes up and it says UC1074. And we can look back here and see that is the correct one, serial number. Okay. So just for convenience, I'm going to add this quick platform there. And now we'll go ahead and add it. All right, and we see it comes up as an SP110, which is incorrect. We know this is a SI121, and we can look at our cal sheet that came with the unit to know which model we're connecting, which one we had bought. So we choose model, but we actually, whether it's an SI111, 121, 131, or 1H1, we just do the SI-1XX. So we click there, and now it's asking us for the M coefficients and the B coefficients, which we can see over here on our sheet, this top row and this bottom row. And it really, as you can see, these are the same. They're just written in different multiples of each other. So we'll go ahead and just do the CR basic model. So for the C2, it says we need, so we'll hit clear, and then we'll do 201015 C1, we hit clear, 192.193.24700. Next one, CO, clear that out, and this is 31251600000. Come down here to C2, clear that out. Actually, the B coefficients of C2, so we have 1689.7. C1, clear that out. 162906. And then right here, we'll hit clear. Now we need a negative, so on iOS, I just hit the negative button right there. And then 186870. Then I hit done. Now if I want to give it a name as well, and we can just name it right now, let's just name it, you know, desk. Okay? Just so we know which one we're talking about. And then we can add it. Okay, so we see that it's added desk, and we see that it's giving us some values right here. OK? Okay? So, let's go in to it. And there we go. So now it's, before it, when it said 24.1, that means it had not loaded the calibration coefficients, but now it has. And if we went back out to that screen, okay, now it's finally updated saying, okay, we're calculating those values based off what you input. So, well, let's go into it. So this is our home screen, okay? It says logs available for collection, 2,300, okay? Now, in our case, we don't believe that. That must have been previous, so we'll clear that out, okay? That's fine. Clear that to zero. Now, down here, these values will not update until we get log data in here. So you can tell that we don't have any log data saved to the app to look at, and so that is why it says January 1st, 1970. Let's go to live meter mode first. So we go to live meter mode. Now we can get our dynamic graph here that is changing, okay? And based on this, again, we're just in here in our studio, and we can see that our temperature and our surface temperature are about the same. Now if I put my hand in front of the unit here, so now we're measuring my outside temperature of my hand, we can see that it's somewhere around 27 to 28 degrees Celsius. And we can change that, and the graph is going to change accordingly, okay? And you can see the sensor body is nearly identical. I mean, that's very small changes, but obviously just being closer to that did increase that sensor body temperature a little bit as well. Now, the important thing about these graphs is it is not logging. This is just live data right now since we came in and pushed live. If I go out of this and I go back here and then I go back to live meter, it has reset, okay? And so now it is logging again, just giving us our spot measurements at our current location. And again, it will just dynamically change with that, and we can see those graphs. Now, if we want to record individual points, this comes down here, and we just hit record current value, okay? So it did a time date, and then it gave us our surface temperature, and then it gives us our sensor body temperature. And then if we want to record value here, we can see that, surface temperature, sensor body temperature, and we just hit recording values. And then if we want to export data, we hit export. It comes up with the line item of each one, and then we just hit that familiar button up there, which is the share button, which will allow us to just attach that straight to an email and email that to ourselves. So, this is live meter mode, perfect to verify that our coefficients are in, perfect to see spot measurements. Okay, so, now, currently it is updating that averaging every second. Let's say we wanted to go 5 seconds. So if we go back to home here, and then we click on settings, okay? And we're gonna go through each one of these settings, but first one, let's look at live data averaging, which is about third one down here on settings as we scroll down. And it says averaging samples over 1 second. So if we move this over to 5, and it can go as high as 30 seconds, okay? So we go to 5, okay? And then we come back here to live meter, okay? So now, it's doing 5 second averaging to get all the way up there to that 28. So it was increasing but it was still takes the 5 seconds averaging before it got up there to the 28. And we'll see that slowly fall off as well, just based on the 5 second averaging. All right. So that is live meter mode. And again, it's giving us those same values that we'd see in live meter right up here under current reading. So let's go through settings now. Now, just in case you wonder if you entered your coefficients wrong, because that was a lot of numbers, they are always available right here under settings. So you can pull up your sheet and double check yourself anytime. Now, if for any reason you lose your cal sheet, just email us at techsupport@apogeeinstruments.com and we can email this information over to you and you can re-enter it into your microCache. So everything looks good there. Logging enabled is turned off currently. We'll come back to that and turn that on and set that up in a little while. We talked about live data averaging. Here's some points here. The battery level says 100%. This is not very accurate, so do not trust that level. You can email us at tech support if you have any questions about your battery levels. Okay, hardware and firmware version, okay? And then match current time. So what you want is you want the time on your phone to match the time on your logger. And so you just hit match current time, and then it goes through and it just makes sure that those two sync up together. Now down here is update sensor firmware. It's always a good idea when it's new to go ahead and click this. Even if you have the latest, it's not going to hurt anything. So right now it says version on device is 5, can't update to version 5. I know you can't see that because it's very light on that screen, but you'll see that on your own. So if I hit start, then down here you can see that it's going through some things. It's gone red here, so it's going through the bootloader. It's uploading the current version of firmware here, okay? And then it's going to come down here and completed. Now you'll notice it's not complete until this start button goes green, because that means it reconnected to it again after it had reset itself. So we are all set on the firmware. Okay, so that's your basic rundown on settings. Dark threshold, that doesn't affect IR readings. And then notify when full, you can click on that so that once those 400,000 data points have been filled and you log in and connect to it, it will give you that notice. So you can turn that on as you want. Now, logging enabled. So we want to set this up so that it can log. Now, on the quick start instructions, as we said, we recommend 15-minute log times so you can get your 6 to 9 month battery life out of the microcache. If you do less than that, then it's going to shorten it. If you go as short as minutes, then you will reduce the life down to weeks. If you go to 1 second, it may be 1 week long is all the battery will last on this. So make sure as you're setting up your logging interval and your sampling intervals that you're aware of that. So again, we just have this one set up. I'm going to go out to 1 minute, and I'm going to go logging interval 15 minutes. So get this on 1 minute, get this down to 15 minutes. Okay. All right, so it's going to average 12 samples to average, and then it's going to log that average every 15 minutes, okay? Now, until I hit save, it is not enabled, and then once I hit save, it has now saved it, and it is now logging internally in here, okay? So our logging is all set up. So if we come back here, it says 0 for collection because it is waiting to do that every minute, okay? But then how do we... So then we deploy it, set it up wherever we want, and then let's come back in an hour or 2 hours, whatever our plan is, okay? And we want to collect the logs. So we go right here to collect logs, okay? And we want to be on create new because this is the first time we're getting our logs, okay? And we can set the date, okay? So we can set it, so let's do June 2020, or you can set to the date, whatever you want, okay? Start time, okay? So if we set the start time to 0:00, and then if we collect logs up to today, it will say logs remaining 65,000, because from since this sensor's been used, there are 65,000 logs on it, okay? So it's going to go through and download each one of those. Now that's going to take quite a while. And then it will graph it down here below, and then it will graph it down here below, and you'll be able to see that. All right? So we'll go ahead and we're going to set that one aside. And then we're going to look at this one on how to append logs and what log data would actually look like. So right here, we have it here in front of us. Okay? And we can see it's a road temp in the front. So what we want to do is we want to connect to it. So we're going to push the button down till it blinks blue. Wait for it and set it connected right up. So we see right here, we have our two data points here, our target temperature and our sensor body temperature. We go into it, okay? And it says logs available for collection is 1, okay? But we actually, so if we go to collect logs, now, I know that there is actually a week's worth of data on this, where we were measuring the temperature of just our walkway out front here in the summertime. So if I go start date, okay, and I go to create new, okay, and I can data set 5, okay, so let's just say, so studio demo, just to name it something, okay, and then for the start time, let's go back a week, okay, to Thursday, and then end time today, okay, so I want to hit, and then I hit collect logs, okay, and you can see that the collect logs, collect, start time, create new, go back a week, Thursday, let's do midnight, to today, collect logs. Okay, so it is saying that the only data it has is 3 days. So the data that was that I was looking for is no longer was erased off before the presentation. But nevertheless, we have our data points from the last 3 days, as well as the data point that it had logged in here. So anytime we want to get new data points, we just hit collect logs, make sure it's on append to existing, and then we'll collect logs. It says there are currently 0 available to log. And then down here we can see our sensor body temperature. And then if we want to export that data, we go to view data, we click here, and then we can go ahead and get those data points. All right, well that concludes our quick start guide for the IR sensor with the microCache. If you have any questions, just email us at techsupport@apogeeinstruments.com. Thank you.